Twin Cities homeowners, home buyers, and realtors. It's eXp Realtor David Garvis coming to you. Hey, the fall leaves are changing. They're dropping to the ground. The air is crisp. And we've got three quarters of 2020 real estate data to take a look at. So let's put Data Dave to work, have him show you what's been going on in our Twin City housing market.
Let's start this month by looking at supply or new home listings, where we see that even with 10% more homes coming to the market this September compared to 2019, we are still down about 2% year to date. Buyer demand, however, exploded last month with 20% more home sales than a year ago and pushed us up over 2% year to date. And of course, with supply remaining low and demand high, our home prices just keep pushing higher, up over 10% for the month and nearly 8% year to date. Finally, let's look at our crystal ball number of months of inventory, where we see that 1.7 months of inventory is way down from the seller's market that we had even a year ago, and promises we'll continue to stay in a seller's market for the months to come. Now, let's get updated on some of the big items happening through the first three quarters of 2019, and of course, no conversation about 2020 can begin without talking about the coronavirus's impact on our housing market. The index to track the impact of the virus uses four components of the housing market to track the impact of the housing market throughout 2020. Doing that, we see the market started out strong, then hit a sharp drop-off in March when the pandemic hit, but for the last number of months, the housing market has recovered in this V-shaped recovery, leading us above the mark where we were before the pandemic hit. A very good sign for our housing market. And another positive item about the 2020 housing market has been with interest rates, as we see rates continue to drop, leaving us at about 2.87% to begin October, down over 2 points from just 2 years ago. And 2 points is significant, as we see that $1,000 would pay for principal and interest payments at today's rates on a $240,000 loan. Compare that to 2018's 4.9% rate, when the same $1,000 payment would have only allowed you a loan of $188,000, 25% less than what you could get today. So while interest rates continue heading lower, we can expect buyers dashing to every home listing. And finally, a quick update on the scary news of the Minneapolis condo market, one of the few areas we see our monthly supply increasing, all the way up to 6 months at the end of September. For perspective, guys, let's take a look at a 20-year chart where we see that that's the highest number since the beginning of 2012. And it's continued to trend higher. So while we mostly see clear roads ahead to finish off 2020, there is just a bit of news to keep October feeling a little scary to some people.
All right, you guys, that's what the three quarters of real estate data looks like. Those are some updates of the things I've talked about so far in 2020, and I'll be sure to keep a lookout on what's going on for the fourth quarter. I hope you have an amazing autumn. Enjoy these colors, enjoy this weather, and we'll see you next time.